Hello to all the real Quake junkies out there. This should bring out a chuckle or two. How many of you have ever had these scenarios happen to you? Ever been out and about or driving around somewhere and have this uncontrollable urge to hook to something or somewhere? LOL. I was doing a side job with a satellite installation company in downtown Chicago last summer, and I was atop a 40-something story building. It was around lunchtime and the stomach was starting to growl. I looked over at the edge of the building and saw a Vienna beef hot dog stand below. All I could think about was how cool it would be to have hooked to the light pole next to the stand, grabbed my grub, and then hooked back up top. The more I thought about it, the more I daydreamed. Over to my right was the Sears Tower. How awesome would it be to fling myself across 15 or so blocks, and just as I was losing momentum and about to crater, hook to the top floor of the Sears Tower and scare the hell out of some family of four, and then continue on to the Hancock. It was about 10 minutes into this that my boss jarred me back to reality. How many of you have been lying there in bed after having just played Quake 2, 9, 10 hours straight, and you're in that not quite awake, not yet sleeping stage, and then all of a sudden you violently strafe left to avoid a rocket and damn near throw yourself out of bed, or find yourself convulsing, trying to drop that rune? Give me a hail yeah, DeathAngel, if you have a similar story.
I've crossed over to the dark side. I use the rail now.
All right, you owe me about 60 bucks, man, because that's what I got in my pocket.
You started your car recently?
Yeah, he did. You can start up again if you want, man.
I wasn't sure. I hadn't heard it running.
Medic!
Make it stop.
Help.
Make it stop. Make it stop.
Let me out.
It hurts.
Help.
It hurts.
Let me out.
Gods of Mortality in its entirety could never be contained to a Quake 2 map. The real GOM lives on in the memories of its members, countless hours of online gameplay, and good times fragging with one another, and all those gigabytes of grunt gibs floating around out there somewhere in cyberspace. The greatest attribute of Clan GOM consists of the members, past, present, and future, that wore its tag. If you see any of our members fragging away, be sure to give them a mighty hail. In the darkness of an endless night, amidst the coldness of a land without sun, our spirits dwell in a land of emptiness, calling out for new warriors to join us and to help spill the blood. I summon you to walk with us, to war with us. Give rise, O noble soul, may we together watch the civil ones fall, and once again allow the ancient ones to rule. I bought my first computer in January 1999, a 400 megahertz Pentium 2 with a 17-inch monitor. I paid just over $3,000 for it. And like most newbies, had no idea what to do with it except tinker with programs I knew nothing about and look for my favorite actresses on the net. When I hooked up, the internet was not yet in the majority of homes. I was one of the first in our town to get cable since I worked there, and it was mostly just surfing. Google itself was only about a year old when I connected. I thought Ask Jeeves was the coolest thing I ever saw. For those of you that don't know, GOM was founded July 22nd, 1999. God of Mortality's full roster over time has included over 100 members, many gone now, but not forgotten, and continues to grow sort of like a fungus on the toes of the Quake community. At one point along the way, someone introduced me to the CLQ, Champions League Quake, which was, I might add, almost the demise of us as a clan. I found myself playing only to get a better ranking, and got really frustrated when I did not or could not perform. Note to all, the CLQ is evil. For what it's worth, GOM made it to the number one spot on CLQ 2 weeks in a row, and number two weeks in a row. And with the exception of dropping to number six once, we have remained in the top five Lithium 2 clans for 16 straight weeks, longer than any other clan that I know. The main concern for Gods of Mortality, however, was never to be the best clan out there or the biggest, but to have the most fun and to meet the best people. In that respect, GOM is and always will be number one in my book. The first annual Gods of Mortality Pow-wow took place in Monroe, Michigan at Venividivici's home the weekend of August 8th, 9th, 10th, and 11th, 2002. Those that made it to that first pow-wow, M1, Murderous One, DeathAngel, Furback, ZiggyZ, Big Johnson, Venividivici, Duro, and Prowler. Some of the best people I've ever met are in Gods of Mortality, and lifelong friendships have been established. Even if GOM dies as a clan, the experience and friendships it has brought me can never be replaced. I will forever be grateful to all the members in this fine group for riding this crazy train with me, past and present, and looking forward to bigger and better things in the future. Give Gods of Mortality an almighty hail next time you see us on the battlefield, and you might just get a hearty, "GOM is in the house," salute right back. Rock on, DeathAngel.
This is Michigan at Vinny's house. The rest of the guys went out to breakfast. We already ate, so we're hanging out here until they get back. see the lake off in the distance.
Bike.
Hold that big
how was it?
Smooth, sweet, and
there
a lot of fun.
Go. There you go. You'll be able to get there.
Cool. There's another one somewhere up there by the steps, but I could never find it.
Booyah!
You had to bring it up, dude.
Huh?
You had to bring it up.
Why not, man?
AT&T.
Why not?
They fuck me.
Well, I fuck everybody. I left with it, and I had your back.
Hey,
hey.
Why is your hand empty, dude? Where's your beer?
That's a good question.
See?
Thanks for asking. See, hey. Saved my life.
You better start drinking, dude.
I will.
Right now,
actually.
Yeah, come on.
You know,
fuck
you.
Yeah, of course, man.
Did you see the sacrifice? Hey, Duro.
Hold on.
All right.
You know what? That's the most intelligent thing you said all day.
I feel a lot better, too.
Okay,
you didn't have your... No. Vixen's trying to get online. She's trying to...
She is?
Trying to talk, yeah.
For real?
What? For real.
Fuck the shit all night.
Hey, BJ. You got Vixen on her?
That's what I was doing right now.
You talking to her right now or no? Yes or no?
Yeah, I'm fixing it in just a second.
Hey.
ZiggyZ.
Hey, this is ZiggyZ. How you doing?
The newest member of the second newest member of GLM.
Yep, that's right. The 100th member. 100.
Well, actually 100, but yep. We don't complain. For those of you that don't know, M1 actually recruited Furback, but it took me a long time before I agreed to the transaction.
What? Eating Doritos without my knowledge? Well, that's just not right. Hey, who are you talking to in here, man?
Does Vixen have a mic on her computer?
Yeah. Are you talking to her?
Yeah, on the chat thing.
Is she in there? Hello, hello, hello. Oh,
Misty, man, the fucking brains.
What up, Dale?
Karina!
We're getting reconnected.
What the hell? Where's your foot pedal at, Vinny? You got the tags on or what?
Oh, yeah, you got
them on. Huh?
You got them on.
What's up, brother?
What's up, man?
Wrong bet. Wrong bet.
Really?
You got the water poopy shred.
And one.
You're in last place, dude.
Did you see Matt when he went that pond? It was like a magnet, you're not coming out.
I gotta get a bit of video card, man.
How do you play? Keyboard and mouse?
Oh yeah. Same, pretty much. Mouse is on my right.
Come on, 63.170. What the hell is TOAD on, man? VDVDVDVDVD.
Don't know what I clicked on, because I know what you're going to say.
You're on, like you, dude. You're on candid camera. You can't lose. Come on,
yeah, man.
Man.
Shit,
this is going. This is going. This is going.
Baby,
this
no hook 'em.
This is going on a documentary.
Oh, it's gonna be on it soon. Be zooming in, baby.
It'd be like
he is gonna be zooming.
I can see it now. I can see it now. Dura will be like the night GOM. The night GOM disgrace. Still getting on here. Oh, here we go. That'll make a good picture. I don't know if I'll... Yuri, why don't you videotape it and I'll try to get a picture of it. It's already recording right now.
I don't know if
you'll be
able to
get it
with my camera though, because... I was
gonna where's it going? There it at?
The problem is... Yeah, the problem is if you try and focus it right now, it's going to be focused on the bush, and when I come in frame, it's going to be out of focus.
Oh, you can't set the focus.
Yeah, let me... You can manually do it, but that's the problem. I would need someone to stand about where I'm gonna, about where I'll jump.
Actually, you could probably, you could record it.
What do you want me to do?
You could still frame it.
I can, what do you want me to do?
Record and jump it off the car.
Oh yeah, there we go.
Yeah, I could do that.
You could take a snapshot of it off the camera.
Well, I'll just, something like that.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll take the video, right? I can catch some emotions and capture that one particular video frame and save it as a still.
Yeah, right.
Who's jumping from what?
On a, kind of against the bushes.
Okay.
Kind of a map, since you can jump off right here. You just stand there.
Right about. Try to jump off this thing right here. Get a ladder, we can get him jumping off the peak of the roof towards the fire right
here. Excuse me.
Do some flame hopping, lava hopping. That's something we should have done. A couple people running over, jumping through the flames.
What are you doing?
Just steering him.
I'm on.
3, 2, 1, jump.
Count down, 3, 2, 1, jump. All right. 3, 2, 1, jump.
Catwoman before, but in Monroe, Michigan, Brett Buchanan is known as Catman, and it's for a very good reason.
And we actually rescued her from, she was a feral cat out in the lake. And
Brett Buchanan is a feline fanatic.
I think they're an awesome pet. I love all animals, really. But they're pretty low maintenance. They have their own attitudes. They have very unique personalities. They're just really fun, loving animals.
So after spending several years breeding cats, Brett found himself constantly wanting to help these delicate creatures.
She's a Turkish van, which is a rare cat that likes to swim. Kind of unusual to find as a feral cat.
This is Taylor, the family feline.
We just love playing with our cats and trying to find new toys for them, and found that eventually a lot of them went stale and decided to make something better.
And that's exactly what he did. It's called Edible Animal Treats, or EATS for short.
Catnip is a relative of the mint family, but yeah, they eat it and it actually provides them with vitamins and fiber and helps cure fur balls.
What started as some simple treats...
This is Pawbreakers, the original catnip candy toy that we started with about 4 years ago.
...has turned into a potential world record. This is the biggest catnip in the world. How big is that thing?
9.5 inches, and we've actually entered it into the Guinness Book of World Records. They have given us a reply and allowed us to, you actually have to be approved to enter it. And we're testing this on a rare white Bengal.
Sam Thomas is Brett's partner.
And the products we make are just so unique that it's a motivating factor to work here.
Besides, I mean, what is it about the cat?
They're a lot of fun. You don't have to watch them. When you leave, they take care of themselves. They're a very independent animal, and they're very affectionate.
They certainly are. In Monroe, Michigan, Joe Rognoski, Fox Toledo News, First at 4.